We're pretty good.
What season did you start wearing?
In the first season, they tried curling my hair. I had to sleep in curlers. I was 12 years old and sleeping in curlers. And they'd spray it with that Pantene. That was a really good stuff to hold your hair tight. And then I'd come in and we'd do the curling iron and burn my hair with that and then put it up in the ringlets. And then they'd have to like redo it. Like every few minutes, the hairdresser was chasing me around with a curling iron and a brush because it would just start to go. It'd be humid and it'd go and it'd go. And so after a couple of months of this, I said, well, this is insane. And it looked like the show was going to keep going for a while. So that's when they had the wig, and it was custom made. They put a plastic bag on my head and drew a diagram and brought in this wig maker and matched it to my hair and everything. So it was a completely custom made Nelly wig. And I had a huge metal comb that dug in right here. That's why I always had this like woo-hoo-hoo expression. Because my head would be pulled back 24 hours a day. Jammed this comb in and a lot of pain, so it was really uncomfortable. I mean, that's the pained expression was from the wig. My scalp is practically bleeding. But it looked fabulous. Oh yes, we really got in trouble. It was so hilarious because Willie was also played by Jonathan Gilbert, who was Melissa Gilbert's brother. And he was very willing. He really was. He was constantly getting in trouble. And so whenever Willie, the stand in the corner stuff, we all broke up every time he did it. And he was really good at it. I mean, there's a scene where I sort of elbow him and shove him off the bench in school. And when we did it, I said, okay, I'm not going to hit you hard, because he was really little. He's much smaller than me. So I barely touched him. I was like, move it, Willie. And I just barely tapped him. And he shot off that bench and slammed into the wall. I mean, he was really good. And he's totally staged. He's like, I got it. Watch this. Bam! And right into the wall to the floor. And so he was great. He would just do the, what? What? Do you know he never read the scripts? Strangest child. When he started, he was really little and he didn't read very well. So his mom would just read him his lines, this is your line, okay. And then he got older and he was still not reading the scripts. He would just memorize his lines. Just read his part. And I said, you seriously don't read the scripts? Because he kept asking questions. And Melissa, his sister, said, I'm not going to tell you. Go ask somebody else. So he came to me and I said, well, why aren't you reading the script, the rest of the story? He said, I like to be surprised when I see it on television. You are seriously weird. But it kind of made sense, because that's why William was always walking around like, huh, what? People would walk into the room and see him and go, oh, what are you doing here? And so he always had that startled quality. It kind of worked. Very funny. But, you know, then there's that episode we had where we had a funeral, and we're standing there, and he's in his little suit, and he's looking so sad, and they have the fake rain, the umbrellas, and the Reverend Alden's reading the thing, and Jonathan turns to me and goes, who died? Never read the scripts. Absolutely crazy. Yeah, he was a great actor because all that Willie stuff. I mean, yeah, like I said, he's like flying across the room, pratfall. He's really a natural born comedian. Yes.
When you were acting, how was your academic?
Were you homeschooling, body acting? Well, I stayed enrolled in my regular school. I started at Gardner Elementary, and then I was at Bancroft Junior High, and then I went to the famous Hollywood High School. And I was in junior high when the show started. So some people would leave school and just do a tutor, or they would go to a private school. And on the set, you have tutors. The set is kind of glorified study hall. They have a set teacher. And set teachers now, sometimes they're really slacking off on the rules. They're not getting good people. In our day, we had really good teachers. With Marianne Fife and Helen Lanier, they were really good. And they could actually like help you with your stuff. But you bring your assignments from school, and as long as you fulfilled your 3 hours, basically doing your homework on the set and going through your stuff, you were good. If you were smart, you would occasionally ask a teacher, you know, for instruction. Now, Melissa Gilbert and Melissa Sue were there constantly in every single episode, so they even had to have the teacher give them tests and some of their major exams. So it's hard because things like chemistry and science lab, you can't really do. You're not going on any class field trips. They're starting to do stuff through Screen Actors Guild, there's a thing called Looking Ahead, and they're trying to work with the schools to like bring a van out so kids can do lab stuff that they need to do for their credits if they're working on a set. But I was okay. I had very good grades before and sort of medium grades. I wasn't like, I didn't really like school that much, but I was really good. English, no problem. Science, pretty good. Math, eh, I had trouble with algebra. Well, you know, if you miss chapter 9, the lecture, you're pretty much toast. because it all builds on the chapter before, and I wasn't in school that day. So I would like work for a couple weeks, go to school for a few days, work for a few days, go to school for a few weeks, which is great because I could make friends. But it did make it very hard, the continuity thing, if it's school and all the set. So it probably, I would say, did affect my academics quite a bit. I did finally, you know, get out of school, graduate, and drop out. And I eventually went back and took some more courses, so I can now actually balance my checkbook. But some people, you will meet a lot of ex-child stars who are just a mess, that can hardly read or write, because the parents didn't really ride herd on them, they didn't have a good teacher on the set, they didn't follow up, so it's very difficult. A lot of kids are homeschooling now who are working, and even then you've got to make sure you got the right books, you got the right people doing it, because it's really hard. You get tied up in the work, and you wind up not doing your homework, and then you wake up and you're 18 and you can't read. Not good. Okay, you do it.
Sam would like to ask, was Albert really part of Laura's family in real life or just on the show?
Aha, the famous Albert question. Or as those book people over at Laura Palooza said, he's not in the books! It's true, Albert Ingalls was totally made up, because in real life, you were in Ingalls. They did adopt some kids, and also there were adoptions a lot on the prairie. But it's not in real life, not in the books. Only on the TV show they decide that they adopted a kid named Albert from the street named Albert Ingalls. This was totally an invention of Michael Landon and the writers. They just thought they had discovered this kid actor, Matt Labrateau. He had played Charles Ingalls as a boy in a flashback, and they liked him. He was really good. And so it's like, well, we're moving to a new town. We can adopt this kid. It'll be awesome. He'll be on the show. And so that's kind of started it rolling. It's that, as they say, jump the shark thing. Suddenly they were adopting everyone in Minnesota. And how many kids did the Eagles adopt on that show? That's when it kind of like went from the books and went, woo! Like over here, and suddenly they were 27 new cast members. So he was awesome, but now Albert Eagles does not exist in real life or in the books.
Were you
and
Melissa Grover?
Yes, it was really hard to keep a straight face. When Melissa and I would fight, we would completely crack up. In fact, the mud scene, you could almost catch us, because there's a couple times in the mud scene, they're filming further back, and they said there's no sound. So we're like screaming and laughing and yelling stuff out. You could probably catch us laughing.
How old
were
you when
you
started?
I got my very first job when I was 6 years old. I did a commercial for Hunt's Ketchup. I was trying to put a tomato in a bottle. It was this running theme of ads that kids put tomatoes in a bottle. And I tried to put a tomato in a bottle, and my tomato burst and splattered all over me. And that's when they found out a 6-year-old could swear. I'm not talking about that Nellie Olson reputation.